At the historic East Preston Depot, Melbourne's ageing tram fleet is being pulled apart. Stripped to just the bare frame as part of a $230 million refurbishment.
A deep engineering overhaul. So we're taking all the bodywork off, we're getting into the chassis, we're repairing the subframes, we're dealing with the power units.
After decades on the rails, many of the city workhorses are showing signs of wear and tear. And a number of former automotive workers have been hired to help give them a new lease on life.
It's a fantastic opportunity for myself personally and others in the automotive industry to share their skills and knowledge, be given opportunity to work in another industry.
Over the next 4 years, 450 trams will be stripped back and partially rebuilt in the hope of improving their reliability. Some have been on the streets since the late 1970s. More than 200 others were built in the 1980s.
On average, each tram will spend around 6 weeks here in the workshop, and transport officials are confident passengers will notice a difference once they're back on the rails.
We're completely replacing all the visible contact points of the tram. The sides, the seats, the windows, the curtain, the poles that we hold on to, everything's getting a real overhaul because we want these trams to be fit for the future.
But the Public Transport Users Association worries that extending the life of high-floor trams by up to 15 years could cause ongoing problems for wheelchairs and prams.
We can't have this situation where there's a portion of the population that just simply cannot use the tram network.
It's also questioned how long the government plans to keep the oldest un-air-conditioned trams.
Air conditioning obviously isn't an issue right now in winter, but in the height of summer, I think everyone dreads getting on board a tram that has no aircon, sweating it out all the way to your destination.
This is about making sure that we have sufficient rolling stock to continue to provide for the growing demand in tram services that we have on our metropolitan network.
And while a handful of new low-floor trams are on order, most Melburnians are headed back to the future. Andrew Lund, Nine News.